I call the Ascension Parish Council meeting for Thursday, February 19th to order. Our invocation tonight will be led by Father John Carrigan, and our pledge will be led by Mr. Howard Dalton, the chairman of our Board of Adjustments. Father Carrigan?
Father, we thank you for this evening and this time to come together, and we thank you for a country where we have the freedom to participate in our government on the local level and up to the national level. Before this evening, I thank you for the opportunity to pray for our elected officials, as you command us to do in Scripture. I'd ask that each one of these councilmen here would receive your blessings, would receive your wisdom, would receive your prudence, that you would give them the right choices to be made, that they would seek your guidance. I'd ask your blessings upon their families, their children, that they would have health and that they would prosper in this land. And Father, as we come together this evening, let us act in a way that's honorable to you and as your children. In Christ's name we ask it. Amen.
Amen.
Mr. Howard?
Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of our country. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Susan, take note that Councilman Joseph and Councilman Thompson are missing.
Prepared work.
I don't have any chair additions, emergency items, public comment period. Anyone wishing to speak on any item on the agenda tonight, please sign in with Ms. Suzanne. You'll be allotted 3 minutes. You will have to stick to the agenda. Talk what's on the agenda. Before we get going further, I would like to, our own Rick Weber of OEP, I'd like to congratulate Rick for this week being, he was honored, the Region 2 Homeland Security Directors of the Governor's Office of Homeland Security and Emergency Preparedness, GOSEP for short, honored Rick Weber as Louisiana's Regional Director for 2009. That's pretty strong. Rick is from our Ascension Parish, head of our OEP, and we're very proud. Congratulations, Rick. I'd like to wish a speedy recovery for our parish paralegal, Ms. Kimlin Bailey-Lomas. Our parish paralegal, Kimlin, had surgery. She's doing well, and we need to get her back to work quick. We get to our presentation part of our agenda, number 5A. I do have a speaker, Mr. Nicky Prejean, please.
Mr. Chairman, if I could follow Ms.
Okay, sir. All right. Ms. Martha, would you come up and it's Rubicon Chemical Recognition of Achievement Award by the Environmental Protection Agency and the Louisiana Department of Environmental Quality.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the Council, President Martinez. Adrian Thompson was not able to be here tonight and asked that I present this in his behalf, your behalf, and the parish president. Tonight is a great pleasure to have the opportunity to recognize one of our own industries, Rubicon Chemicals. They have been a support of Ascension Parish, making numerous investments, contributions to our community. But tonight we're here to recognize them for the National Partnership for Environmental Priorities Award that was given by EPA recently to them in Washington, D.C., and also recently at our Geismar Community Center. This award is presented by EPA for obtaining the goal and reducing of quantities of benzene and aniline incinerated by the facility by 1.2 million pounds. NPEP is an EPA program that promotes voluntary reduction of hazardous chemicals. Over 222 partners across the country are in this program, which promotes alternatives to hazardous chemical use, including recycling, substituting of hazardous, less hazardous alternatives, or reducing quantities of these hazardous chemicals being used. It is truly a merit that Rubicon Chemicals was able to accept this award by EPA by volunteering their company. In doing this, it reflects Rubicon's commitment to Ascension Parish, community, and the environment. They have been a continuous example of being a good neighbor to our citizens in that area, and has been really an asset to us, not only financially, but by services that they provide. At this time, I would like to ask Mr. Drew Fillingame and Mr. Shannon Arsenault, to join me for this presentation by Parish President Tommy Martinez and the Council.
By awarded to Rubicon Chemicals LLC 2008 Honorary National Partnership for Environmental Priority. The Parish of Ascension is proud to present this certificate of achievement in recognition of attaining the goal of 1.2 million pound reduction in the amount of aniline and benzene incinerated at your facility. We join the EPA, Louisiana Department of Environmental Quality, in recognizing this achievement. Your voluntary participation in the National Partnership for Environmental Priority and your commitment to the reduction of hazardous chemicals. Congratulations. Keep the good work up. Thank you. Congratulations, Shannon. Thank you. Also, we want to thank you and Rubicon to the Parish.
Rubicon has committed to safely produce our products in a way that does not put our workers or our community in any sort of risk. And this award is for an effort that that we undertook that's above and beyond the requirements of our permits and the regulations. It's a voluntary waste minimization project, and we're proud to be recognized for doing what we just think is the right thing to do. Thanks.
Thank you. Mr. Nicky Prejean, please.
Thank you. Fortunately, I was able to work at Rubicon in 1964 and 65 when the plant was originally constructed in Guysville. Since that time, they've been a very good corporate citizen. They strive to do business locally, and if at all possible. And through the last several summers, they've provided school supplies and meals at the Dower Community Center, and at the Geismar Civic Center, and at, I think, Ms. Rayburn's church, but a sum of some $80,000 or $90,000. They have provided school supplies and the meals for the kids during this summer tutoring program. And I want to thank you for allowing me to speak and on their behalf. And since I'm congratulating people, I'd like to congratulate Ascension Parish Fire District 1 today on the Mississippi River in Dara for the local fire departments, save Marine Company located here, $25 million by putting out a tugboat fire in about 2 hours.
Wow. Thank you. Very good. Thank you, Nikki. And thank you, Rubicon. We'll move on to the next section of our presentations. We have the Santa Maria, East Ascension, and Dutchtown High Schools, the All-State and All-District Achievers. Would y'all come forward, please?
Skip one, B.
One at a time.
All right.
What about B?
Who?
B. Item B. Mike Evers.
I'm sorry, Councilman. We will skip item B. Mr. Evers will not be in town until the next meeting.
Okay, good.
The Economic Development Director. Councilman, we will also pass on number 8. Okay. Go ahead, sir.
Last meeting, we were proud of our students from the West Bank, student athletes that attained special honors during the past football season. And tonight we get the honor of our East Bank cohorts. So it's always a pleasure. All outstanding young men. We kill it with this community in the future. And as you grow, hopefully some of you will become leaders in this community. So I just want to congratulate all of you tonight. We're going to honor each of you. I want to congratulate all the student athletes that take part in sports. It's better to do that than do other things that are available out there. So we certainly have the Parish Council and Parish Administration, I want to congratulate you for getting that. First of all, the Spartans from East Ascension, Coach John Lambert. Coach him? Okay, I'm sorry.
Coach
Jason Brown. Coach Jason Brown, good to see you. First team All-District, Matt Reshaw, defensive back. And also recognize the second team kicker, kick returner. Adam Thompson, offensive line. Second team all district, Mr. Wade Julian, defensive lineman. Ryan Maul, defensive lineman. Tough one. Kadarius Lomas, defensive lineman. Finally, Mr. Trey Greaves, linebacker.
I'm Jason Brown. I'm representing Coach Lambert tonight. He is at a girls' playoff game right now in basketball. I just want to thank the council for recognizing these young men. They work very hard, all these young men in this room, and they deserve all the credit that they get.
Oh, yeah, like to, can y'all scoot in a little bit for me? Tighten up.
Yeah, see y'all.
You want those tall ones?
48, turn your shoulder out for me, and 94, scoot in, shoulder out, for, like that. Ready? 1, 2, 3. One more. 1, 2, 3. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Congratulations. Next, the Santa Maria High School Gators.
Go Gators.
Thank you, Mr. Blue.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to hear a count.
Somebody found him.
David Oliver. Okay, Gators, second team all district, Mr. Marvin Martin, defensive lineman. Zach Whittington, linebacker. Chase Keller, wide receiver. Chase DeLatt, offensive line. Trey Vaughn, return specialist. And Mr. Justin Manton, punter.
We'd also like to thank the council. We're extremely proud to have these young men represent Santa Monica High School, not only for their athletic ability, but they're fine students and they're also great kids. So thank you all very much.
If I can get your shoulder out for me and tighten up a little bit. Yeah, I need, can y'all tighten up just a little more for me? One, two, three. One more. One, two, three. And ready. Okay, thank you. Congratulations.
Good job, man.
First team all district, Mr. Richard Buckland, defensive lineman. Eric Reed, defensive back. Eric is not here today.
All right.
Richie, Randy Thackeray, linebacker. John Lambert, offensive guard. Kobe Little, tight end. Kobe's not here. Okay. That's your first team. Second team, all district. Marcus Godfrey, defensive back. Marcus is not here. Grant Medine, defensive lineman. Wesley Perkins, quarterback. Kelvin York, running back. Sean Cook, offensive guard. Thomas Harvey, center. Evan Reed, who's not available tonight. And also we have first team all district and all state, Mr. Eddie Lacy, running back. Mm-hmm. Not here.
I also would like to thank the council for recognizing our athletes. We have a number of kids who
got one more.
Grant and Dean.
We missed one.
Oh.
Yeah, Grant's here.
Come on up, Grant.
I mean, Grant Austin. I'm sorry, Grant Austin.
Say his name again.
Grant Austin.
There you go.
Kicker and punter.
That's right.
I also would like to thank the council for recognizing our athletes. It's been a great pleasure to coach these guys. Most of them up here, with the exception of Grant, are seniors. And I know that they'll be very successful in life because of the way they worked while they were in high school. And again, thank y'all.
So we can get as tight as possible. Tighten up number 51. Shoulder out a little more, please. Shoulder out as much as possible. Can y'all tighten up on this side a little bit for me, please? Come on, y'all huddle up tighter than that. Come on, tight. Smile. Ready? One, two, three. One more time, please. One, two, three. All right. And more. Okay, thank you.
Ms. Suzanne, before we move forward, Councilman Joseph is now present.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, the next item on our agenda, Parish President report. No report.
I don't have a report tonight. Thank you.
Move to item 7, consent agenda. Councilman, look them over. And I'll need a motion.
So moved.
Moved by Councilman second. Moore, second by Councilman Kent Shakeschneider. Any discussion? Any objection? Motion carries.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
Before we move on to number 9, since we passed on number 8, I guess I got a question on it. Why is the reason that we passed on it? Because I think this project is waiting on us to close this project out with this change order. And it was voted on at finance to move forward. And this project is not going to be closed until we move on this change order.
Did you have anything on that, Councilman Moore or Councilman
Lutton? Is there a reason why we're passing on it? It came out of finance to bring to the full council.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just other than looking at some of the numbers here, Mr. Lambert, I'd like to relook at this.
I know we done passed on it about 3 transportation committees, and now it got to the council, and we're passing on it again. So, just curious.
Okay, sir.
Point of order, Mr. Chairman.
Sir.
Is the finance chairman pulling it? I mean, who's pulling it?
Councilman Lambert.
Mr. Lambert, it's not up to Mr. Lambert to pull it. It went through chairmanship.
I'm okay.
If you want to pass it, Mr. Lord needs to say he's passing it.
He has. All right. Item 9. Councilman, what I need to ask y'all, I need a change of our March 5th time, move from 7 o'clock to 5 o'clock p.m. And the March 19th meeting moved to March the 12th. Move it up 1 week. I need a motion.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, ma'am.
May I ask a question?
Sure.
That is the same day as the Finance Committee meeting where you have both finance...
Yes, ma'am.
Finance at 6 and regular meeting at 7.
That's right. Yes, ma'am.
Say that again. Go ahead.
March 5th, 5 o'clock p.m. March 12th at 7 o'clock p.m. The several councilmen going to Washington, and councilman also be at the state convention.
So moved, Chairman.
Moved by Councilman, who said that?
I did.
Councilman Valentine.
Second.
Second by Councilman Cullen. Any discussion? Any objection? Motion carries. We move to item 10, ratification of contract between Ascension Parish and Ascension Economic Development Corporation. Councilman Kent Shakesnyder.
I'll handle that. Mr. Shakesnyder's name got put on it.
All right, President Martinez.
Basically, it's a renewal of the contract that we've been doing with the Economic Development Corporation. It's for $341,000 a year, and it goes through 2011.
So moved.
Second.
Second. Moved by Councilman Lohr, second by Councilman Dempsey Lambert. Any discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Councilman Lambert.
Yeah, Mr. President, I guess 3 years ago when we formed this, they formed the Economic Development Corporation. They came in front of the council and asked for this fund and said it was going to be a three-year period, and at that time they were going to be self-funding. And I'm just wondering where we're at on that. Here we are renewing it again for the $340,000. I thought by this time, you know, a few of y'all wasn't here when this took place, mm-hmm. but when they presented it to us, it was just a three-year deal, and then they were going to be self-funding after that. So I'm just wondering.
I don't think that's happened. evidently,
is this a renewal for how many years?
Until 2011. They approached us to renew the contract. I think we have two members here if they want to speak on it, Mr. Lohr and Mr. Kluat on there.
Yeah, go ahead, Chris.
I'm just going to say... I'm not sure of the history of it, but as far as whether or not it's still needed, I definitely think so. I think you get into economic development, what you put into it, and they still are in need of these funds based on all of our meetings and discussions to operate, and I think right. we need to make
it. Because it is an independent corporation. It's not affiliated with the parish, so I want everybody to be aware of that.
That's correct.
Okay. Councilman Joseph.
Once again, it's a finance issue, and we asked for renewing, and it didn't come to finance. I don't recall seeing this on the finance committee.
There's a timing.
To discuss it.
I'm sorry.
Councilman Lohr?
There's a timing issue with the contract, Councilman Joseph, and we actually, on the next finance agenda, we're going to revisit the entire discussion around contracts and all of that and how those things flow, because we've been running into issues. We had it with the jail last the last council meeting, things like that. So I think we just need to lay it all out and come up with an orderly plan about this, because we're kind of running into some roadblocks with timing based on the way we have set up.
Is this our committee, the way we have them set up, or just the paperwork just not getting to the committee in time to fashion?
I think it's mostly just we need to work out some processes, that's all. So we can discuss
it. You got a 30-day cancellation clause. Any party can cancel within a 30-day period. So if you have a problem there, you have that escape clause.
Any more discussion? Any objection? Motion carries. Item 11, resolution. Ms. Martha Collins, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, gentlemen. This is a resolution tonight to authorize Parish President Tommy Martinez and Gwen LeBlanc for the financial to sign the appropriation corporate endeavor agreement. We were afforded by the state legislature $19,000 for our recreation. That was a line item appropriation, and we are actively trying to pursue this and finalize it, so we need a resolution from you.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Moved by Councilman Todd Lambert, second by Councilman Benny Johnson. Any discussion? Any objection? Resolution passes.
Thank you, sir.
Item 12. Martha, are you handling this resolution also?
I can handle that.
Okay, Councilman Shakesnyder, in support of Gerard Labatt for State Director of USDA Rural Development.
That came out of the River Region Caucus meeting that they had.
Mr. Labatt is a very close friend and native of St. James Parish, and he's in for rural director, rural development state director, which would have an effect on funding for our rural areas. And the River Region Caucus was in support of him, and they asked each of the councils within the River Region to also send resolutions of support. So
I'll make that motion. Motion by Councilman Kluwer.
Second.
Second by Councilman Dennis Cullen. Any discussion? Any objection? Resolution passes. Item 13, intergovernmental agreement between the Parish of Ascension and the Ascension St. James Airport Authority for the purpose of the parish assuming ownership of a certain modular building manufactured by Morgan Building Systems, model number 14501CTXX2CA, and valued at $5,000.
Motion.
Second.
Motion by Councilman Kluwer, second by Councilman Dempsey Lambert. Any discussion? Any objection? Motion carries. I have a resolution, Ms. Gwen LeBlanc, please. 2008 Louisiana Audit Compliance Questionnaire.
Good evening, gentlemen. You have before you in your packet the resolution.
Ms. Gwen, hold up, please. I'm getting old enough, I skipped 14. On 14, I have two speakers. Ms. Goppa will be first, and Mr. Hillensbeck will be second. Ms. Goppa, please.
Good evening, Council. President Martinez campaigned for returning drainage operations under the management of the parish president.
Ma'am, before you start, let's do it right. Don't mention any names, all right? Talk on the agenda.
This is a public meeting doing public business, open for public debate, protected under the First Amendment of the Constitution and Louisiana open meetings laws. If you can't take the heat, get out of the kitchen. President Martinez campaigned to return drainage operations under the management of the parish president. Here are his words in a public forum at the Pasqua Theater, aired on Cox and Etel prior to the October 07 election.
Until the board voted to hire its own administrator, do you think there's any advantage to reverting back to the parish president administrating the drainage work?
I think it's the worst mistake the parish ever made. I think we need to revert back and put it back under the parish president.
Drainage operations have been managed professionally, efficiently, and projects have moved forward over the last 2 years while separated from the parish government. This agreement returns to the parish president the exclusive right to administer maintenance operations, repair, and provision of drainage. The 2009 East Ascension drainage budget with capital projects totals $42 million, or 46% of the entire operating and capital budget for the parish. The administration's plans to review current capital projects leaves the door open for the current 10-year plan to be changed, including the redistribution of the $60 million borrowed for capital projects. Returning the reins to the parish president is not a business decision. You could save almost $500,000 in administrative costs each year by separating completely from the parish. You've never discussed the facts in public because they do not support the decision you're making. This is a political decision. Drainage will now be used as it has in the past to politically punish those who do not bow to the wishes of the parish president. A councilman who refuses to compromise and cast a vote as a favor may find work orders or projects in his district placed at the bottom of the pile or set aside altogether. This has happened in the past. Officials suggesting getting away from the police jury system either don't understand the politics or are willing to sacrifice serving the people for their own political gain. This dedicated task has been abused before under the same management. Financial firewalls and promised accountability have their loopholes. Citizens will be watching carefully. If the past is any indication of the future, we can look forward to failed policies, failed projects, money lost, and more lawsuits. You may have it your way, gentlemen, but history shows it will not serve the people or responsibly use our resources. Thank you.
Mr. Hillensbeck.
Well,
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the council, Parish President. Good evening. I'm former Councilman Doug Hillensbeck. I live up in Prairieville. And I'm still in favor of going back and putting drainage under the Parish President like it was for so many years, and I'd like to go on record as being in favor of that. Now, when this issue came up, I strongly opposed it. I said it was not cost-effective. It was we were creating more government bureaucracy, and we were going to be, in the long run, less efficient, less cost-efficient, and less cost-effective. Now, I visited today with members of the Parish Finance Department, and this very move has cost the citizens of Ascension Parish an additional, on top of operating expenses, normal operating expenses, an additional $2 million plus in support and operational costs. And I challenge, or I invite any of you to go check that out and have that meeting with the Finance Department. I got those numbers today. I'm not going to call names, not all of you, but some of you sitting at the table tonight vigorously supported this measure. However, tonight, you have an opportunity to right the wrong for the betterment of Ascension Parish. I remind you, you can do a lot with an extra $2 million. You know, you can pay your employees more. You can help them out with insurance, et cetera. You can do more. You can clean more ditches. So as I was then, I am still in favor of putting it back under, and I encourage you to do so. I had some other things I wanted to bring up tonight, but I'm going to adhere to the rule about the chairman mentioning staying strictly on the issue.
Thank you, sir.
But I will be at a drainage board meeting soon when we start talking about the current bond issue that this body passed. As a councilman, I questioned a lot of decisions by the council and the drainage board. Many times didn't sit well with members. I was falsely accused of bickering by people with opposite views and political objectives. If you do approve this tonight, I'll feel somewhat vindicated and with the position that I took. In closing, I don't want to sound too critical of reporters. I would just like to ask reporters in the future, try not to report just he said, she said. It would really be of great benefit to the people of the parish to go out and do a little digging, or I'm not sure what the proper term is, maybe gumshoe work or whatever, but get the staff's cost and the projections of matters of such magnitude. $2 million is a lot of money. And I'm sure as many newspapers as I helped you guys sell the last four years previously, you'd probably go along
okay,
and
sir,
help me out on that.
Sir, your time is up. Thank
okay.
you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, members of the council. And again, I urge you to put it back like
Item
it used 14, to be.
Item 14, intergovernmental agreement between the Parish of Ascension and East Ascension Drainage Works.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we, that Parish Council enters into the agreement with the East Ascension Gravity Drainage District as proposed.
Second. Well, a motion by Councilman Clouard, second by Councilman Dempsey Lambert. And discussion?
Yes, Ken.
Councilman Valentine.
Yes. Once again, let me reiterate some of the discussion that has been taking place. One of the things that I was definitely against was putting it back under because of the guidelines and the safeguards that I had asked strategies to be put in place to make sure that the money was spent for drainage. This is a dedicated tax. Once again, I'll state the parish did not lose any money. It was just spent in the drainage department where it should have been spent. The problems of the past has been that the drainage money has been spent to supplement salaries of other people in administration for handling drainage issues, which I believe is against the law. I don't think Ms. Lindsay, Ms. Manda, I was going to ask you tonight, and I'll put you on the spot, but you don't have to. We don't have an answer on the 4% total yet, Ms. Faltzman was looking at.
What was your question about
the 4%, I'd asked her to get an opinion on that.
I did do some research. We can't get an official Attorney General opinion within a week. but if you'd like, right. I'll go ahead and send that off.
Yes, I would appreciate that. If it takes a vote of the board or have it takes, maybe the parish president can suggest. I think he can recommend it, and the attorney general does that with that request. But that is one of the things that why I will not vote for it's this approval tonight, simply because I do not think that the parish can charge the drainage board, which is a dedicated tax, more than 4% for administrative costs and any expenses incurred. In fact, loss is actual cost, up to 4%. So that's why I would be opposed. Thank you, Chair.
Any more discussion, Councilman? President Martinez.
I just want to say to Ms. Goplett, I still stand behind my statement, so I'm not going to waver on that from the beginning to the end. And over this whole process, we've heard a lot of accusations. Again, we hear the word illegal. So I would certainly encourage you to make a motion to call a legislative auditor in and check during the last whatever years, if you'd like to do so, so we can clear the air and all these accusations will be cleared up. You know, I don't have a problem with that. I'd be happy to do so if that's what you like. So as I said, you know, we don't need all this. We don't need it being said by anyone from outside or inside. So I encourage you to think about that. And if at some point you choose to do so, I would certainly support that and encourage it.
Okay, is there any more discussion, Councilman? Yes. Quickly. Councilman Shakespeare.
Thank you. Yes, a number of years ago, excuse me, when we decided as a council to move the drainage away from parish government, there was some management issues and some questioning about what was happening. And the situations at that time, I believe, and I strongly felt, dictated that we move drainage away from parish government. Since that time, things have changed. We've had a series of small informational meetings, working meetings that as councilmen we got together and looked at the problems that all councilmen had an opportunity to bring up, and administration had taken notes and given us a synopsis of how we can look to take care of these problems and administer them in a correct way to protect the people and show what the concerned citizens are concerned about to protect and make sure the money is being well spent the way it was destined to. I've come to the conclusion that it will be spent in the proper manner and that the administration's implementation strategy is a correct one. And so, therefore, I will support putting it back on the administration. And if the administration's implementation strategy is not followed, I will be the first one to propose that we take it back and put it where you can control that. So I have no objection to doing this because of those reasons, and things have changed since that time. Thanks.
Okay, sir, any more discussion? Any objection?
I object.
Okay, roll call, please, Ms. Suzanne.
Councilman Kluwak.
I'm for it.
Councilman Cully.
For it.
Councilman Johnson.
Yes.
Councilman Joseph.
For it.
I'm sorry. Yes or no?
Yes.
Councilman Dempsey Lambert.
Yes.
Councilman Todd Lambert.
No.
Councilman Laurel.
Yes.
Councilman Shakespeare.
Yes.
Councilman Valentine.
No.
Okay, we'll move to item 15 now, Ms. Gwynn.
Okay, good evening, gentlemen. You have before you an annual resolution that is required to be passed in accordance with the Louisiana laws to conduct our 2008 audit. And it's rather lengthy, so I'll just briefly recap it for you. Like I said, it's required by law as part of the audit process. The council is required by law to adopt it by resolution. Questionnaire basically states that we are complying with all laws governing the operations of parish government. and we are disclosing all pertinent information to our auditors. Also, that we are presenting a fair presentation of our financial statements in compliance with generally accepted accounting principles. And this questionnaire states that we, and by we, I mean the council, the parish president, and myself, we are complying with the public bid law, the code of ethics law for public officials and public employees, the local government budget act, accounting, auditing, and financial reporting laws, asset management laws, fiscal agency and cash management laws, debt restriction laws, revenue and expenditure restriction laws, road system administration laws, and the law governing drainage districts, fire districts, and other special districts, and also the home rule charter mandates. So I'll just quickly read the resolution. It's a short resolution. Be it resolved that the Council of the Parish of Ascension, State of Louisiana, hereby adopts the Louisiana Compliance Questionnaire for the 2008 audit of the government of the Parish of Ascension. Be it further resolved that the Louisiana Compliance Questionnaire be presented to auditors Falk and Winkler, said audit firm, approved by the Ascension Parish Council and the State of Louisiana Legislative Auditor.
That's it. Okay, thank you, ma'am. I need a motion, please. Moved by Councilman Todd Lambert.
Second.
Second by Councilman Randy Kluwak. Any discussion? Any objection? Resolution passes. Thank you, Ms. Gwynn. We'll move into our planning, zoning recommendations. Mr. Ricky Compton, please.
Zoning review ID 1954.08, tract A1, Robert Thibodeau property for Time and Regina Harp. Located on the east side of LA Highway 73, approximately 1,500 feet north of LA Highway 621, to amend the Ascension Parish zoning map from medium intensity residential RM to mixed use 2, MU2, the Zoning Commission voted to approve this rezoning to accept or deny.
So moved, Jim.
Moved by Councilman Valentine. Second by Councilman Dennis Culley. Any objection?
Discussion. Mr. Compton, I just wanted to make sure you were okay with this as far as administration's opinion and how this fits into what we're looking at for the master plan.
Yeah, what happened with this parcel is we asked them to delay until the mixed use 2 came forward. They actually came forward for a mixed use zoning because I guess about 3 months ago, a parcel adjacent to it was rezoned to mixed use. And we asked them that they had no plans for the property. They just felt like if they got some commercial zoning that they'd be a little better off. So we asked them to wait for mixed use too. And they were applicable or they were open to that idea. So yeah, it's fine with what we're planning.
Great.
Okay. Any more discussion? Any objection? Motion carries. Thank you, Ricky. 17, introduction of an ordinance to amend the building department's fee schedule. Councilman, we all have schedules here for Mr. Laverne Bourgeois. Laverne, would you like to speak on this?
Mr. Chairman and Council Member, I actually gave that out as a courtesy information from the Finance Committee last week. Mm-hmm. And if any gentlemen have a question, I'd be glad to.
Make a motion approved. Yes.
Motion approved by Councilman Joseph.
Second.
Second by Councilman Lohr. Any discussion? Any objections?
Thanks.
Ordinance is introduced. Number 18, introducing an ordinance granting variance to the... Before we get to 18, Councilman, I have Mr. Wesley Babin to speak, please.
Good evening, Councilman. My name is Wesley Babin. I'm president of American Industrial Plant Services. We've been in the Santa Monica community for quite a number of years doing industrial fabrication items, plant outage items for refurbishing units to ensure that the items are in working order for some of our local plants and businesses. We are applying for an variance to the ordinance, to the noise ordinance, because we are currently having to work some additional work hours outside of the applicable hours in the ordinance, such as night work and weekend work. We employ a total of 61 employees, 38 of which are from the Ascension Parish community, 13 from Livingston Parish, and 10 from other parishes. We last year in 2008 paid out a total of $1.2 million in wages approximately to Ascension Parish employees or employees of American Industrial that live in Ascension Parish, a little over 3,000 to Livingston Parish employees, and other areas over 400,000. We received some of our major revenue from local customers such as Praxair in Ascension Parish, Occidental Chemical in Geismar, and Honeywell, totaling over $3 million in revenue from those alone. Our total revenue for the company is just under $6 million for last year. I also have some more items here, which is a noise control plan that I'd like to offer into record, along with these other papers that show the figures that I just spoke about. We already have implemented some procedural controls. We plan to implement a barrier along our western boundary, which seems to be the most area of problem, to help alleviate some of the noise problems. But I'm asking for this variance until I can get some of this stuff in place. We do not always operate around the clock at our facility. So this is a temporary issue for now. I'm asking for the ordinance to be issued till the end of March. All of that is listed in these items that I'm going to offer for record.
I'd like to speak.
Councilman Clouard.
I'll make a motion to introduce.
Motion by Councilman Clouard.
Second.
Second by Councilman Dennis Cullen. Any discussion? Councilman Clouard.
Yeah, Wesley, when you basically, you know, you're working 24 hours a day, and then, you know, we had a noise complaint on it, and everybody went check it out. And I think most of the councilmen here have kind of checked that out also. You put in a request for variance to the noise ordinance, and you brought your request to me on February 9th, and the next day I gave, you know, took it to the parish legal attorney of the day after. What is the time frame that you're looking for a variance? You said 6 weeks. That's from February 9th?
Yes, sir. And that's changed slightly due to some material delays that I'm waiting on, some materials currently for our next major project, which is in line for fabrication. I have to be complete with the project by the end of March, so that's when I'm asking for the variance to be issued.
So basically you're looking for a variance from February 9th to March 30th?
Yes, sir.
And?
31st. Yes, sir.
What type of variance are you coming from? And, I guess in my conversations with the Central Parish Sheriff's Office and people that have reviewed the noise ordinance that, you know, pretty much allowed to work weekdays up until basically dark, something like that, and then you in on Saturdays.
Right.
What type of variance are you exactly looking for? Are you looking to work till 10 o'clock at night? You looking to work all night, day
and
night?
We have a shift scheduled from 6 p.m. until 4:30 a.m. currently. On our noise control plan, it listed that I've offered there for record. It's listed that around the week of March 9th, we'll probably begin working 12-hour shifts, which will be 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. and then 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. in order to complete the project on time. So, and also that will take place both basically 7 days a week. In the latter part of that, I dictate that if we can keep from having to work weekend nights or weekend days, if it will not impact our schedule negatively, then I will avoid working during those times.
And within your work schedule, if anybody just at fabrication, you try to rotate most of your fabricating during the daytime?
Yes, sir.
And you're welding at night? You're a welding facility. You're fabricating tanks and vessels,
right,
and piping.
We'll try to do the noise-making operations during the day and least of noise-making operations during the nighttime and again on Sundays as well. We're definitely trying to accommodate the community, but it's not completely possible with the amount of work that I have to get through. And again, we're blessed right now with the amount of work given the economy, the way the economy is, you know.
I guess we'll be able to get a copy of your plan that you'd introduce to the secretary for review.
She has a copy of that. I just ask for the variance so that we can continue to contribute positively to the community.
Yes. Councilman Valentine.
I guess, thank you, Chairman. My question, I guess, might be directed to Mr. Clore. Mr. Clore, are you sponsoring this ordinance?
No, I'm not sponsoring
okay.
the ordinance.
Somebody has to sponsor the ordinance if it indeed is supposed to be an ordinance, which I don't think.
This is going to be a resolution.
Okay, well.
You just told us it will be a resolution.
Okay. Yeah. I'm reading the information I got here, and we at the section
I've
of
I've never done it before, so that's
okay.
why I'm saying.
Well, that's why I'm reading the information I got, and it doesn't really give you a process. It just says that they may request a variance. Yeah. So I would think that would be done, and that contract would be drawn up and then brought to us. Mm-hmm. And I would suggest that's what that take place. I would think I'd like to see that in front of us on what it's going to amount to.
A contract?
Well, how else would you do it? We're certainly not an ordinance. That's what we got
right.
now.
Right. It would just be a motion, a resolution. With whatever terms
and
restrictions
would
that you
what?
All would want to place on a variance should you choose to grant it.
Councilman Joseph.
Okay, the other information I'd like to know is what committee did this go through? We hadn't had a chance. Typically, we wouldn't discuss this at a regular council meeting. One, it's being brought to us in a wrong form to start off with. Second, now we're going to vote on a resolution, which we need to have the facts in front of us. They've been quoted to us. We have some letters in front of us. But essentially, we haven't had a chance to discuss this in a committee setting.
Yeah. I guess, Mr. Valentine, I brought it to the parish government, to
okay.
administration and legal. And, you know, I have a request from a constituent within my
right,
district.
I understand.
And where does it go from here? And that's what I was told was based on the ordinance, that the noise ordinance is that they can apply, and I think Mr. Babin actually asked for an application. Is there an application using the term apply? Okay. And there's none to be found. So whatever legal wants to do with it, that's what he's trying to seek the requests.
I would ask legal to give us a suggestion. In other words, you're saying all we need to do is pass a resolution if we agree with it or disagree.
If you're in favor, you could grant his variance until March 31st and restrict the hours of operation. Should you so choose, you could deny the application for variance.
Okay. I guess my other comment would be, and I'm not sure if this was stated before, but I'm not sure this is the only time that we've had complaints from this particular company.
Yeah. And I agree with you on that he's had complaints, and that would be to the sheriff.
For noise.
Yeah, for noise. But I guess when my conversation with legal back to the ordinance or whatever you want to call it, resolution, is that it needed to be introduced here tonight and that it would go through the public hearing phase of where the public would be notified that we will be coming back to us. That would give those folks that live there an opportunity to come here and refute their case.
I would think you'd right.
That's exactly what
I
was
think
told.
You'd be right.
So
we're still looking for direction up
somebody
here.
Somebody that's a little bit more than a lawyer than me, please clear it up.
We introduce this as an ordinance. Next meeting, it'll come before us as a public hearing.
No, the ordinance states that this must be advertised, notice to the public in the same manner as provided for ordinances. So this should have been advertised in the paper, notice to the public, and then tonight they would have had an opportunity to speak, and you could have voted by resolution to, you know, deny or grant the variance.
Councilman Joseph.
Yes, and I'm going to go back to committees. I thought we had a variance board committee that you bring this to, and they research it, and then they recommend that they provide the variance or don't provide the variance, deny it or approve it. Then it comes to us on there based on their recommendation. And
we can sure send it that way.
you
That's
know.
For zoning.
So my recommendation is to go to the variance board and ask for, and I understand the situation, but if we're going to start this process, and I do not know the variance board on this situation here, do give a variance. I know they give variance on properties and stuff like that. Yeah. But
yeah. Tell me which committee it needs to go to, please, somebody.
Councilman Chick Snyder.
Well, and Lindsay, correct me if I'm wrong, this is a situation that doesn't go before the variance board?
Correct. That, okay. That would just be for zoning variances.
Right, it's zoning variances, and so we are the variance speakers for this. Councilman said, I'm also for, I think everything ought to come before committees, because we should not be put into this situation right now, unknowing the facts and having discussion with 11 member council going through this. Not fair to the person that's putting in the application, and not fair to the people that are coming here. We have two avenues for taking care of these things. The Strategic Planning Committee that meets once a month on the fourth Monday. And if it's an emergency and the time dictates that we do something on an emergency basis, which this may be, we have an executive committee, the chairman and two other members that can meet at any time and review things and make recommendations on a timely manner. So I think we need to have these discussions and this information in that manner. We do have, as an offer, we do have a strategic planning meeting Monday, and we do have a council meeting in 2 weeks. If that's a problem, then we do have executive committee that can make recommendations, and we can move forward pending council approval after that. So I don't want to interrupt his your project being done, but we also want to make sure
I'd
the
like
proper
to follow
procedures.
The proper channels to get this achieved as well.
I would like to amend my motion. I'd like to make a motion that would amend it to where we go to strategic planning on Monday with it. If legal, if everybody agrees that that's the place it needs to go.
I think that would be proper. And council members, also note that the sheriff can grant a temporary variance until you've heard the matter and made a final decision. So.
I'll
that is an option
motion.
In the meantime.
Yeah, I have amended motion by Councilman Cloward, second by Councilman Lohr. Any discussion? President Martinez?
I just want to say that according to the ordinance and the law, I mean, all you have to do is publicize this in the paper, mm-hmm. call a public hearing. Now, if you want to take it to committee, that's an option for you. But the law says that you put it just like you would any other ordinance. And you, as far as notifying the public, and then you hear it after that process is over with, then you can grant it or don't grant it. Now, it's up to you if you want to take it to committee or not take it to committee.
That's
but the law doesn't say you have to take it to
I
committee.
I think that's the path I chose, just what you said.
Yes,
and that's why it's here tonight.
Yes, sir. I think
and
you did the right thing.
Give 2 weeks for public hearing for the good people of the rest of Santa Maria that may want to agree or disagree with Mr. Babin to get a chance to put the input and get and come here. So,
any more discussion, Councilman?
So we are approving an introduction of a resolution. Is that what we're doing?
We have.
But explain, Parish President, you need to explain that to me again.
What they're doing now.
This is not an ordinance.
I know that, but the law says that you have to treat it as an ordinance. Have a noise ordinance. This gentleman is asking for a variance.
Right.
Basically, what the law says and the ordinance says is that
he's
asking for temporary. Yeah. He have to treat it as an ordinance in the public hearing process. So what he's doing here tonight, he's notifying you that he's asking for a variance. Now, tonight, you can go ahead and ask legal to go ahead and publish the public hearing, and then you can come and go through the process. But it's not by ordinance, even though it says you treat it as an ordinance.
Right. It may say it treat it, but you don't want to.
Okay. No, I mean, it's up to you if you want to go through committee, but you don't really have to. Since it's only affecting Mr. Cluart's area, not the rest of you guys, this is a variance in his area. But if he wants to go...
I just want the public to have an opportunity to respond and come back to this council.
Sure, that's right. But that's what you need to do. I mean, it's not that difficult.
Well, we made a motion to send it to committee.
We have a motion and a second. Any more discussion?
Do we want to withdraw that and not go to strategic planning after all?
Well...
Councilman Clark?
Councilman Chase.
I have no problem with this whatsoever, but we need to decide whether we're going to go through committee or not, and not pick and choose what we're going to have through committee and what we're not going to do. If we are, we can't just say that the ones we all agree on, we're not going to go through the committee. Yes, by law, we don't have to. We don't have to do anything.
But that's up to you.
Yeah, and it is up to us. But if we have a policy, we should follow it.
I think I have a motion on the floor for it to go to committee, and I think we've got a second.
And we have a second, and we're in the discussion mode right now.
All right, we'll go to strategic planning. Thank you all.
Councilman, any more discussion on the amended motion? Any objection? Motion carries.
Pat, Lindsay, can you get all the information and be able to present it? Okay, thanks.
I have several speakers. Before we get to reading of the ordinance and the public hearing, I'd like to call up Commissioner Murphy Painter, please, to speak. How are you, sir?
Mr. President, members of council,
Chairman.
Mr. President, I'm here to answer any questions on an information basis, so I'm not having
the commissioner's here to talk to or answer questions on the ordinance that is fixing to be read. Lindsay, would you read the ordinance, please?
Purpose: to amend Chapter 4, Article 2, Section 4-27 of the Ascension Parish Code of Ordinances to provide for certain exceptions for licensing and permitting dealers in alcoholic beverages. Whereas the governing authority of Ascension Parish has been given authority to regulate the licensing and permitting of retail and wholesale dealers of alcoholic beverages in the unincorporated areas of the parish, and whereas the Ascension Parish Council recognizes the need to amend the current ordinance to provide for certain exceptions regarding eligibility for these licenses and permits, therefore be it ordained that the Ascension Parish Council in lawful session hereby amends the ordinance regulating the permitting and licensing of dealers of alcoholic beverages as follows. Section 4-27, denial of permit or license to premises in proximity to churches, schools, etc. Exemptions, exceptions. Except as otherwise provided herein, no permit or license shall be granted for the sale of alcoholic beverages for any premises situated within 500 feet or less of a public playground or of a building used principally as a church or synagogue, public library, or school. This distance shall be measured as a person walks using the sidewalk or, if no sidewalk, the roadway from the nearest point of the property line of the church, synagogue, public library, public playground, or school to the nearest point of the premises to be licensed. Exemptions. The prohibitions of this section do not apply to any premises which are maintained as follows: a bona fide hotel or fraternal organization, a gasoline service station deriving less than 50% of its income from the sale of alcoholic beverages, providing that no sale of alcoholic beverages take place between the hours of 7 a.m. and 3 p.m. on days when school is in session, and any premises which have been licensed to deal in alcoholic beverages prior to the introduction of this ordinance on November 17, 1994. C. Exceptions. A license or permit may be issued to a premises located less than 500 feet but not less than 300 feet from a public playground or of a building used principally as a church or synagogue, public library, or school if the following criteria are met. The business must derive less than 50% of its income from the sale of alcoholic beverages, and the business applying for the license or permit must be part of a building or group of buildings housing at least four adjacent retail stores or service establishments, and the individual business must not occupy more than 30% of the total square footage of the commercial development of which it is a part of, and the total square footage of the development occupied by businesses that sell alcohol may not exceed 40% of the total square footage of the development.
Okay, ma'am, once I go to public hearing, Councilman, I have several speakers. Before we do that, any discussion with Commissioner Painter about this ordinance?
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Painter, you're charged with enforcing the alcohol ordinance, correct?
That's correct.
Can you give us some background as far as where we're going to stand if we were to introduce this ordinance tonight, where we, the Ascension Parish would stand as compared to other parishes around the state.
Well, certainly alcohol is an issue that polarizes people in just about every community in the state. The northern part of the state still has a number of places that are dry. In fact, there's one parish that is still completely dry in the state. When you get in the southern part, you have a little bit different mix. The issue that y'all having is an issue that goes on 10 or 15 times a month through our office. It's always an issue of who wants or doesn't want something next door to them. In all fairness, there's a number of parishes that have no limit whatsoever. You can put whatever you want next to whatever you want. They still have some parishes that have no licensing system whatsoever. Now, the overall majority of them do have some sort of measurement that's done. The legislature has allowed municipalities and parishes to measure in a straight line now if they want to, instead of the way that was talked about in your reading. In a city, it's 300 foot is the limit. In an unincorporated area, it's 500 foot. And it mostly reflects what's going on in that particular parish. If you have a parish that's growing, certainly it reflects a closer distance. If it's a rural parish where you have no industry or no growth, pretty much, then nobody is there to complain about a 500 foot rule. I would venture to say that the majority of issues wound up at 300 foot. Now, that would be for a restaurant. Now, we're talking about specifically for
a restaurant,
what the
correct
state calls a bona fide restaurant.
And Mr. Painter, some of the other comments I've received were concerns around a restaurant perhaps one day turning into a bar. Is that possible, and if it worked to happen, if it was possible, would you be charged with making sure that doesn't happen?
It's certainly possible, but if the system is worked on the state level the way that it is, a restaurant state license that you get as a restaurant has to have, when your ordinance said the majority or less of the alcohol, less than 50%, the state says the primary commodity has to be food and food service, and you have to take uncooked food, prepare it with a fully equipped kitchen, and serve it for consumption on premise, and that alcohol has to be served in conjunction with food service. Now, those two things kind of box that in. It also says food has to be served every day of operation. We have a 500 square foot minimum square footage of habitable area inside of a restaurant, and anyone that has a restaurant has to maintain separate sales figures that can be audited at any time that a question comes up to make sure that they are selling more food than they are alcohol. Now, the viable catch to all that is, if you put a place in business and its intention was to be a viable restaurant or a bona fide restaurant, and then for whatever reason it changes over a period of time, and most of the time it's because of economics and you're not serving enough food, and it's a lot easier to sell alcohol than food because of the overhead and stuff along that line. But every year at renewal time, that facility has to file an affidavit under state law that says what their figures are and swear to it under oath. And if they are found to be in or fudging or giving the wrong figures on that particular instrument, it is a public record, and they are subject to be charged with filing a false public document and looking at a 5-year felony for doing that. Now, do people do it? Yes, they do. And we pursue those from that point. But there's a check and balance every year at renewal time to make sure that they are maintaining that balance.
Well, last comment, gentlemen, and thank you, Mr. Painter. Part of what Mr. Painter was saying about a restaurant establishment, bona fide restaurant, and I will propose this after the public hearing. I'm going to amend the original ordinance just to be 100% sure. It was always about a restaurant, and as you can tell from the original ordinance, but after speaking with Mr. Painter, we wanted to make sure we included language from the Louisiana state law and the Louisiana statute specifically defining what a bona fide restaurant is, so that there is no chance of loopholes or anything like that. And so we'll be tightening that up, and I'll be presenting that later, but I appreciate it, Mr. Painter. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Mr. Painter. Open a restaurant. A lot of restaurants you see nowadays have a bar to the side, so someone can go there and drink, you know, consistently for hours and leave the site, you know. And we're concerned about being next to our kids, you know. The library is right there. They said in the ordinance it's set from between 7 to 3. Well, the kids are in school, but they use the library after 3 o'clock. That's when the library gets used, and our kids are going to be there. And I guess, you know, it's saying a restaurant, but originally I think this was supposed to be a daiquiri shop, and then they changing up to put it as a restaurant now. But in a restaurant, they have a section that you can put as a bar, correct?
The bar in a restaurant area, Councilman Lambert, has to be used in conjunction with fulfilling the requirements of that food service and restaurant. Now,
but also they can sit at the bar and drink.
They can stay in the bar and drink as long as it's segregated.
Correct.
Either by walls or by no one underage.
So slash, this could be a slash restaurant slash bar.
Well,
in a roundabout way.
And it can have a bar in it that facilitates the service of alcohol without serving food. Mm-hmm. But if it ever advertises as a bar.
Right, I can understand that.
Or it's ever stopped, the kitchen shuts down.
But realistically.
And something along that line. Mm-hmm. Then, and we're in the middle of a number of issues like
right.
that in East Baton Rouge and some other areas over some similar things. But if you take the law as I read it as a whole, there's no way that it's supposed to be able to operate as a bar, strictly a
right.
bar. And if it does, then it has to have a bar license in order to do that.
But I guess realistically, you know, I've been in restaurants and seen it take place. You know, it can happen, you know, and that's why my concern is about moving this ordinance like it is. And as far as the 300 to 500, you know, we've never had any issues with the 500 feet, and that's why I don't know why we want to change it at this point.
And I'm just here to give
it. Yeah, I got it.
Thank you, Mr. Payne.
Anybody else? Any more? Councilman Valentine. One,
I'd like to say this is a little irregular, having someone come to justify something we're fixing to buy on or get information to start off with. I really do think this is out of order. I think we should have put it, but be that as it is, he is an authority on it. So I'm going to ask Mr. Murphy to hang around after the motions are made and after the public hearing is had. I may have some questions for him myself.
Okay, anybody else? We'll move into our public hearing section. I have several people. I need a motion to open public hearing, please.
Motion.
Councilman Benny Johnson.
Second.
Public hearing is open. Anyone wishing to speak, which I have a number of speakers, you'll be allotted 3 minutes. The first speaker we will have will be Reverend John Kerrigan.
Could I ask a question first of what the amendments will be, Mr. Lohr, when you bring them? Will Section C still be in the ordinance, or will it just be a restaurant notice in Part B?
Sure, I'll be glad to share that with you. Section C will not be in the ordinance. Section B, 2, there will be before that, there'll be a definition of restaurant establishment as defined by Louisiana Revised Statute 2673. And then exemption B2, a restaurant establishment that is within the 300 to 500 foot range. That's basically.
Section C.
The exception section will allow for restaurants in the 300 to 500 foot range. And then we have a definition section on what a restaurant is, which is according to state law.
Thank you. Then I would like to speak against the ordinance and the motion. I was involved in 1994 in getting this ordinance adopted by this parish because of a building built very close to our church, and I thought it was within the 500 foot. It was finished, and I found out that the parish had to adopt the law before it became in effect. Whether it was a state law or not, the parish had to adopt it. So I do have a vested interest in this. With the Section C taken out, You take away all the definitions of distance. You take away the definitions of profitability from alcohol versus food. You take away all sorts of different things within that. The definitions of restaurant that are placed in there from the other thing that you're bringing mention nothing about the sale of alcohol. It just mentions the sale of food. It doesn't mention if there's any balance between the sale of food and alcohol. It doesn't mention anything in reference to alcohol in the definition of a restaurant. So you're flawed in that amendment in that way. When a law is passed, it like this, it would impact churches, playgrounds, libraries, and schools, all of which have multi-million dollar facilities in our parish, and it would devalue the property. It would take overflow parking into our property. All those kinds of things would impact us, litter, drunks. Finally, alcohol rules are to protect children more than any other thing. The common denominator between these four things, churches, libraries, parks, and schools, is children. And you're asking the parish to place beside all these places where children thrive, where children prosper, places that sell alcohol and that could impact those children. I think it's a flawed amendment. I think it's a flawed plan. We are an unincorporated area, and we should stay with the state guidelines of 500 foot. Thank you.
Thank you. Excuse me.
Next, I have Ms. Linda Godin.
My name is Linda Godin, and I live in District 11. I'm here tonight just to ask you to keep the same ordinance in place that has worked for our community for the last 15 years. It's pro-business, and it still protects the quality of life for our families.
I have the Reverend Glenda Rick.
I'm simply here today just to say that I think our children have enough to deal with at this time. So many things are going on and so many things around them. We don't need to add more problems for our children, because we must keep in fact that our children is our future. And we must try to save them in every way we can, not add more corruption into them. And even as you were talking about the fact of the being a restaurant, but just even as one of the councilmen was speaking earlier, bars are in them. You know, so many you go in and you know, you don't want to give this. Then they're talking about the hours, even like we're seeing with the library. No, only thing I ask that we just leave it like it is. Do not decrease it. If anything, we should increase it. Thank you.
Cheryl Fondo.
President Martinez, councilmen, and citizens, my name is Cheryl Fontenot, and I live at 14114 Rose Hill Lane in Gonzales. I am here tonight because I care passionately about my community. My ancestors have been here since the early 1800s. As an elected member of the Ascension Republican Parish Executive Committee, I want Ascension Parish to be a safe place for my children and grandchildren. Businesses keep the standard high for the safety of our children. Businesses, including restaurants that sell alcohol, should not be closer to our children. Keep the maximum allowed by law. Keep the distance at 500 feet. Do not lower it to 300 feet. I took the same oath of office you did. We vowed to protect the health, safety, and well-being of our citizens. You are accountable to God as his ministers for good. Do what is good for the people, and you will be praised. Listen to the people, and don't harden your hearts. Good evening, gentlemen. Thank you.
Catherine Guppet.
State law allows businesses licensed to sell alcohol to locate next to a church, full-time daycare, public school, library, or playground, except when prohibited by city or parish ordinance. While cities and parishes may put ordinances in place to prohibit the sale of alcohol within 300 feet or less from these sensitive areas, local governments may extend this distance in rural areas to 500 feet. These are maximums. Ascension Parish did this 15 years ago in 1994 when they passed our present ordinance. This law prohibits businesses that sell alcohol from locating within 500 feet or less from our churches, full-time daycares, public schools, libraries, or playgrounds. The proposed changes introduced 2 weeks ago would drop the 500 feet to 300 feet in the unincorporated areas of Ascension Parish-wide. An amendment to be offered by Councilman Lohr tonight drops the distance to zero throughout the parish. It will allow restaurants licensed to sell alcohol to locate adjacent to our churches, daycare, public schools, and libraries. Either option before you tonight moves us away from the maximum protection for our children. Two weeks ago at your meeting, Mr. Compton, the Ascension Director of Planning and Zoning, stated,
that as we move through the master plan process, we can decide as a community if there's pieces, parts, or the whole thing that we'd like to adopt and make Ascension Parish not just about minimum standards, but about better standards.
You heard what he said. The proposed changes you're doing tonight are the opposite of what your Director of Planning and Zoning is proposing in the master plan being prepared right now. Are you willing to compromise the maximum standard that protects the entire parish to do a favor for one elected official and his friend? Last week, projections released by the state said we will double our population by 2030 to 200,000. Our quality of life in 2030 depends on decisions that you make today. Past leaders had the wisdom and common sense to set the standard for businesses licensed to sell alcohol at 500 feet. This ordinance has served us well. Don't compromise the health, safety, and welfare of our community and our future quality of life. This council is the last firewall of protection. Putting politics over people is an injustice to our community. Keep the ordinance as it is to protect our children. Thank you.
Doug Hillensberg.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the council. I'll be brief. I live off Highway 42 in Prairieville, and I've seen way too many accidents that are alcohol-related, and I'd just like to go on record that I'm in favor of the existing ordinance remaining as it is. I think we have enough restaurants with bars in them throughout the parish. I'd like to see the almighty dollar not make the final decision. Thank you.
Lynn Whitmer, I think I'm saying that right, Whitmer.
Good evening, Councilman and President Martinez. I would like to ask you to not change the ordinance from 500 feet to 300 feet. Schools, libraries, playgrounds, and churches have more protection with 500 feet. I ask that you save our children from drunk drivers. We have the freedom, the right, and the choice to drink, but we don't have the right to kill someone because of our drinking. We already have a problem in our state with drunk drivers. We need more protection, not less. Councilman, are y'all willing to risk the lives of our children to collect more tax dollars? Does money speak louder than people's lives? What happens when a drunk driver kills a child? All I ask is that you make the right choice. I'd like to thank George Valentine and Todd Lambert for standing up for the right choice and for supporting in not lowering the distance. Playing politics with our children's lives makes no sense. Please keep it at 500 feet and save our children from the drunk drivers. And I understand this week it is a restaurant, but next month it would be a bar. So stop it at 500 feet. If anything, extend it to 1,000 and save our children now. Protect them as they play at school. We saw it tonight, all those football players. What happens when a drunk driver hits them and kills them while they play in football or practicing football? When they walk into the libraries, playing on the playgrounds, or attending church? I thank you. And this is my son, and I want to keep him protected. He's handicapped, and I ask that you protect him.
Jeremy Epps.
Good evening, gentlemen. Parish President Martinez. My name is Jeremy Epps. I live at 37348 Dutchtown Crossing. Come here tonight to just ask you to please leave the ordinance at 500 feet. We just can't risk anything to happen to our children. If we change it for this one, it opens it up to put a restaurant that serves alcohol right on top of one of our schools. Perfect situation where I live at in Dutchtown. There's vacant lots. There's land all around it. It can happen. Just please think of our children and do the right thing. Thank you.
Let's see. Oh, I see. Kathy Edmondson, representing the Republican Party Executive Committee.
Good evening, Councilman and President Martinez. Let me get my glasses on so I can see anything here. I'm Kathy Edmondson. I live at 43510 North Pinecrest in Gonzales. But I'm here representing the Ascension Parish Republican Executive Committee. Whereas as Republicans, we believe in the power and freedom of individuals with as few as possible governmental restrictions. As Republicans, we believe that efforts to modify or replace core values erode the foundations of our society for future generations. There presently exists an ordinance in Chapter 4, Article 2, Section 4-27 of the Ascension Parish Code of Ordinance that provides for licensing and permitting dealers in alcoholic beverages. Whereas that an ordinance has been proposed to the Ascension Parish Council to revise the said above ordinance to allow for certain exceptions. A license or permit may be issued to a premises located less than 500 feet but not less than 300 feet from a public playground of a building used principally as a church or synagogue, a public library, or school if the following criteria are met. The business must derive less than 50% of its income from sale of alcohol. The business applying for the license or permit must be part of a building or group of buildings, at least 4 retail stores or establishments. The individual business must not occupy more than 30% of the total square footage of the commercial development, and 4, the total square footage of the development occupied that sell alcohol may not exceed 40% of the total square footage. Whereas the Ascension Republican Parish Executive Committee would like to maintain the present quality of life and safety standards for our parish that are presently in place in the present version of Chapter 4, Article 2, Section 4-27 of the Ascension Parish Code of Ordinance, whereas at the Ascension Republican Parish Executive Committee in their regular meeting evaluated the new revised and proposed ordinance and after discussion passed the following resolution. Be it resolved that the Ascension Republican Parish Executive Committee strongly opposes the proposed changes to Chapter 4, Article 2, Section 4-27 of the Ascension Parish Code of Ordinance and encourages the Ascension Parish Council to vote against the proposed changes and maintain the present quality of life and safety standards presently in force and effect. Thank you.
Reverend Bledsoe.
Thank you, gentlemen. I appreciate the opportunity to be able to address you tonight. I want to thank Dempsey Lambert. He's really been a great help to us, and I want to just thank you for the opportunity to talk to you tonight. I don't want to talk about restaurants or distances or alcohol or churches or schools, to be honest with you. I want to talk about what it means to be a leader, because leadership is a tough thing, and I really sympathize with what you have to hear and what you have to decide. I know this, that I'm a leader in the field that I'm in, and one of the most difficult decisions that I have to make is to keep the standards high. And, you know, I think about whenever I was here the night when the council decided to bring in the new building code. And that's the council made a decision to raise the standard. And I was a little skeptical that night because I was contemplating building a house, and I wanted to see how it would affect me. But you know, I think it's been good because I believe high standards help us to keep our value. And Ascension Parish is a great place to live. People want to come here. I remember when planning and zoning was implemented. I know it was a battle. Not everybody liked it, but it raised the standard. And I just simply say, you know, as people have spoken, people want to move here. I believe it's because the standards are high. This is not the time to lower the standards. This is the time to keep the standards high. I moved into a subdivision that has high standards because I knew that if I invested there because of the high standards, that it would protect my investment. I think Ascension Parish, the same principles work for us. I want to encourage you, because I really believe this is a referendum more on your leadership. Are we going to keep the standards high, or are we going to lower the standards? I believe that the precedent has been set in the past. There's been some good leadership. I know there's been some dysfunction, but there's been some good leadership to raise the standard, because we as a parish, I've always loved what Ascension Parish means. The name Ascension means to rise above. And I just would encourage you to raise the standards, or keep the standards high and not lower them. This is not a time to lower the standards, but it's a time to keep them high. Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to talk to you tonight.
Thank you. Thank
you, Brother. Jonathan Starnes.
Councilman, Mayor. I actually would like to speak on behalf of lowering this. I do commercial real estate, and I actually, you know, work in the greater Baton Rouge area, surrounding areas as well. And I look at this as an equal opportunity deal for the small employee. You know, we deal a lot of leasing and sales with restaurants that do businesses that actually thrive their business in the unincorporated areas. They can't compete with your national tenants, your Chili's, those kind of clients. So it's easier for these small guys. We call them mom and pop type restaurants that can go into these unincorporated areas and start up their business and be able to compete with the surrounding areas, especially in high growth areas where you have a lot of new residential, new housetops. So I understand the safety issues, and you know, safety is first and foremost all the time. I don't think it's fair that you can stop a business from going into a retail center that is within the state limits, but a parish limits sets it out to keep them from being able to start their business and have that opportunity to thrive in that area. So I just want to say that that's my reason for supporting it, and I think that everyone should have a chance.
Mr. Miles Holly.
Mr. Chairman, Council, thank y'all very much. Mr. Lord, I'd like to applaud you for your amending your the amendment to make sure we don't have a bar next door. I don't want a bar next to me. I do want a good restaurant. I do want good jobs. I do want significant investment. I can tell you that going and waiting 30 and 45 minutes at a restaurant with my family is not something I enjoy. I can tell you that this particular facility, the significant investment that's being made, I don't think it's a matter of money. I think it's a matter of the fact that we need this in Ascension Parish to continue our growth. I am for the fact that, we'll have other places to bring our family to enjoy a nice restaurant, and I hope y'all will consider the fact that this will bring jobs, this will bring continued investment into this great parish that we live in. Thank you very much.
Councilman, that's it on my speakers. Need a motion to close the public hearing.
Motion to close the public hearing.
Motion by Councilman Jake Snyder to close the public hearing.
Second.
Second by Councilman Todd Lambert. I'll need to read the ordinance, please. Make a motion for the ordinance.
I'd like to actually make the amended motion, a motion to introduce an amended ordinance as has been discussed previously, and I'd like to, Ms. Manda, if you would read that for the benefit of the group. Everyone has a copy, but if we could read the amended motion, I'd appreciate that.
Purpose, to amend Chapter 4.
Point of order. Before we read the ordinance and get all into this, let's clarify something. We already put an ordinance in the paper. We advertised it. This is an amended ordinance. We haven't even approved the first ordinance for it to be amended.
Right.
So we need, when you amend an ordinance, you have to bring the amendment in writing, not the amended ordinance.
You can amend an ordinance at any time up until it is adopted.
Right.
So there was a public notice about what was going to be on the agenda tonight, and Councilman Lohr is offering an amendment to that ordinance.
We haven't even approved the amendment yet, though. I mean, we hadn't approved the ordinance for it to be amended. Yeah, I understand what you're saying, but there is rules in which you put an amendment to an ordinance.
And you can offer that amendment before it's adopted, and it can be verbal, Councilman Valentine.
And it does not have to be advertised.
No.
Okay.
Ms. Manda, if you would read.
Whereas the governing authority of Ascension Parish has been given the authority to regulate the licensing and permitting of retail and wholesale dealers of alcoholic beverages in the unincorporated areas of the parish, whereas the Ascension Parish Council recognizes the need to amend the current ordinance to provide for certain exceptions regarding eligibility for these licenses and permits, therefore be it ordained by the Ascension Parish Council in lawful session that hereby amend the ordinance regulating the permitting and licensing of dealers of alcoholic beverages as follows. Section 4-20, definitions. Any person engaged in the sale or distribution at retail or wholesale within the parish of malt, vinous, spirituous, alcoholic, or intoxicating liquors containing more than 6% of alcohol by volume shall be deemed a retail dealer in alcoholic beverages or wholesale dealer in alcoholic beverages, respectively, for all purposes of this article. Restaurant establishment shall have the same meaning as provided in Louisiana Revised Statute 26:73 as follows, which operates a place of business whose purpose and primary function is to take orders for and serve food and food items, which serves alcoholic beverages in conjunction with meals, which serves food on all days of operation, which maintains separate sales figures for alcoholic beverages, which operates a fully equipped kitchen used for the preparation of uncooked foods for service and consumption of such foods on the premises, which has a public habitable floor area of no less than 500 square feet. This subparagraph shall not apply to business locations that apply to or have been licensed to sell or serve alcoholic beverages prior to August 1st, 2006 and have not discontinued the sale and service of such beverages for more than 6 months. Section 427, denial of permit or license to premises in proximity to churches, schools, etc., exemptions, exceptions. Except as provided herein, no permit or license shall be granted for the sale of alcoholic beverages for any premises situated within 500 feet or less of a public playground or of a building used principally as a church or synagogue, public library, or school. This distance shall be measured as a person walks using the sidewalk or, if no sidewalk, the roadway from the nearest point of the property line of the church, synagogue, public library, public playground, or school to the nearest point of premises to be licensed. Exemptions. The prohibition of this section does not apply to any premises which are maintained as follows. A bona fide hotel or fraternal organization. A restaurant establishment that is situated within 500 feet but not less than 300 feet of a public playground or of a building used principally as a church or synagogue, public library, or school. A gasoline service station deriving less than 50% of its income from the sale of alcoholic beverages, providing that no sale of alcoholic beverages takes place between the hours of 7 a.m. and 3 p.m. on days when school is in session. And any premises which have been licensed to deal in alcoholic beverages prior to the introduction of this ordinance on November 17, 1994.
Before discussing any further, I'd like to just offer this in the form of a motion.
I have an amended motion by Councilman Lowell.
Second.
Second by Councilman Dennis Cullen. Any discussion?
Discussion.
Councilman Lowell.
Ms. Manda, I appreciate you reading that. Gentlemen, what this is further clarifying the definition of a restaurant according to the state definition in Louisiana Revised Statutes 2673 of what a bona fide restaurant is. So this is the exact same ordinance that we have on the books, but adding an exception for a bona fide restaurant in the 300 to 500 foot range. Again, this is exactly what we talked about the last council meeting. There's a whole lot of misinformation out there and about what the intent of this ordinance is and what exactly it's doing. This is an attempt to clarify that a little more perfectly. And I understand that alcohol is a sensitive subject. I understand a lot of people believe that alcohol is inherently evil. And alcohol is dangerous, no question. I'll offer this as an analogy. So are guns. And I think there's not too many of us, hopefully, that want to restrict guns. Guns kill people. Alcohol kills people. It's all about personal responsibility and your personal morals and how you were brought up. And so if, you know, I understand the concern about a bar within a restaurant, but if someone's going to get drunk at a restaurant, it's there and get out on the roads there and be a menace to society and lack that good moral judgment, it doesn't matter if it's 200 feet, 500 feet, or 10,000 feet. That's their own. We can't legislate good behavior. I wish we could, but we can't. But so it all comes down to this is about restaurants, and whether or not you think restaurants, by their nature, endanger children. And I've yet to hear a logical, rational argument for exactly how that a restaurant would do that. So my amendment, this ordinance has always been about restaurants. And there's a whole lot of misinformation out there. I heard it said that it takes away, it could be right next to it. That's not the case. We are still, the state law is 300 feet. That was also not stated correctly. The state law is 300 feet. Baton Rouge and Gonzales, our surrounding areas, is 300 feet for anything. We are still going to be more strict than Baton Rouge, more strict than Gonzales. As Mr. Painter said, more strict than many parishes around here. This is just allowing an exception for a bona fide restaurant in the 300 to 500 foot range. Still being more strict than most of us, but allowing for some of that growth. I want to see growth in this parish. I want to see quality of life has been brought up many times as well. Restaurants bring quality of life. When we have good restaurants, that makes this place and this parish a more enjoyable place to live and to bring your families. So I understand it is a sensitive issue. And people can get very emotional about it. I've had lots of conversations, I'm sure many of you had. But whenever I've had these conversations with pastors, preachers, or just concerned citizens who believe strongly, whenever I've had these conversations, it always comes once that we clarify exactly what this ordinance is doing, that it's just about a restaurant. I've yet to hear anyone who still it comes down to they just have an issue with alcohol, period. And I can respect that, I can understand that, but I happen to disagree with it because I don't believe restaurants are an endangerment to society, and certainly not when it's in 300 foot to 500 foot range. So I've said enough, but thank you.
Mr. Chairman.
Okay, any more discussion? Councilman Todd Lambert.
Yeah, like a lot of the speakers that came here tonight, I don't think Ascension Parish needs to lower their standards, and I think we need to stay at the 500 foot. You know, I've been to a couple funeral wakes where some parents lose a kid, and it's very tough, very tough. And I don't want to see that happen to if something happens in this ordinance. Why change it? We're changing it for one businesses. Now, it seemed like this business that built here should have investigated this before prior billing. There's plenty of places in Ascension Parish that can put commercial buildings that meets the ordinance. Why build a building before looking at an ordinance? And then after the building's built, come back to us and try to change it. I'm definitely in opposition of it, and I think everybody needs to think hard on this issue.
Okay, any more discussion? Councilman Valentine.
Thank you, Chairman. Mr. Painter, could you step to the mic? Thank you, Murphy. Glad you could come tonight. Mr. Lohr just made the comment that you said we have a state law that prohibits 300 feet. But then I heard you say there are parishes that don't have any restrictions. Is that, I want to know, Mr. Lohr said he's got some misinformation. I just heard something here that is misinformation to me.
I'm not sure what
you said. Some parishes don't.
The state law is set up to, there actually is no state preference per se.
Right.
The state law only gives the minimum or the gives the maximum of what a city can do and the maximum of what a parish can do.
Correct.
As far as ordinance, it doesn't demand
a minimum.
The council do anything, but it says if the parish chooses or the municipality chooses for a city, the maximum they can restrict is 300 feet. For a parish, the maximum they can restrict is 500 feet. Now, a city could say that they don't want to place 100. They could place 100 foot,
right?
50 foot, 200 foot.
But there's not a minimum.
Or they can do 300 foot.
That's all I want to clarify. Yeah. That was just one. I want to make sure that misinformation got straightened. Thank you.
Okay.
Let me talk. I'm gonna talk on the alcohol issue first, and I'm gonna talk on the developer issue. Ms. Cindy Savoy, who couldn't make it tonight, belongs to MAD. MAD naturally would be interested in something like this, but she handed to me today the report that came out this week on Louisiana traffic records data report. And in it, there are several points that are glaring to Ascension Parish with the high standard we have now. One is that our alcohol fatal crashes in this parish are up 30%. That's 30%. Ascension Parish rates for drivers that are fatal injury crashes by parish, drivers ages 15 to 24, Ascension Parish is number 2 in the state. Certainly, Highway 42 has been the basic road that has been talked about as fatalities and accidents. I have already stated that once before. What we're essentially doing, as Mr. Lohr said, as far as bringing economics or bringing up the standard of living with restaurants, we're essentially giving more availability to a person to sit at a bar and grill, as it's been characterized as some of these restaurants. That's what they're called. Chili's Bar and Grill, that's been used several times here, to essentially consume alcohol and then get on the highway. Reason grocery stores or gas stations that sell alcohol in this situation, there's an open container law, and essentially you're not supposed to drink it, although Louisianans are noted for drinking alcohol while they're driving, but you're not supposed to drink alcohol until you're at your place of residence when you buy it from those situations. That's why you see some gas stations that may be located close to churches, some gas stations that sell alcohol located next to schools. And that's the reason. This is a passionate ordinance. People have a lot of passion when they talk about their families or talk about their children. Person that quoted that a while ago, that's about their children, is exactly right. It's about what we want to set and the standards we want to set. I'm, for one, not wanting to reduce our standards. But I was a little taken back this afternoon, and I'm going to go a little different route now, because what I noticed was a report on TV by Channel 2. Dana Hackett did the report. I believe Mr. Storms, I believe your name was. Was on that report. I noticed under the caption that it was Donnie Gyro and Associates, or development company. Am I right? I want to make sure I'm correct.
That's correct, but they're not the developer.
They're not the developer.
We're just handling the real estate leasing.
Okay. Then I'll refrain for what I was fixing to say. I had some, as Mr. Laverne Bourgeois knows, I had some dealings. I have a Sonic 25 feet from my house that Donnie Gyro developed, so that's where I was going. So I won't speak to development, but the developer, whoever the developer is, which I really don't know. I thought it was him at the time, but now I'm not sure this developer, the information I got, lives in the parish or even votes in the parish. He's come in and built a strip mall. I was told it's in the neighborhood of $4 million. That is a sizable investment for doing that. But also, if you're going to invest $4 million in Ascension Parish, I think you would check the code and the restrictions before you build something like that. What's going on in this country right now is government is stepping in and taking care of people that essentially have expanded themselves income-wise beyond their means. They are not taking personal responsibility, and government is stepping in to do it. And that's one thing that I am just completely against. This developer made a mistake and has decided that he wants to correct it, why should this parish correct it, this council correct it with an ordinance that's going to change the whole parish? I mean, I really don't understand the reason behind it, because that's what it is. Even though it's stated around here, that's not what it's want. This would never be before us tonight if this developer would not have messed up and built this in the wrong place, next to Ascension Parish Library within the 500-feet zone. Now, my statement before was he can fill it with something other than a restaurant. But it's obvious he's built it, and he needs people. He needs it to be leased. He needs some income. I'm sorry. If people across this nation that are hurting. I work for a company that hurts. Everybody is hurting. We're in bad times, but it is a bad precedent for us to lower our standards in this parish just to suit a developer for economic reasons, and that's what we're doing. This is not a quality of life issue. This is not worried about waiting 30 minutes in a restaurant. I wait longer than that to get my car fixed, okay? So that I have a problem with. One thing that needs to be done is people that come to this parish to develop need to understand the rules and that we're not going to change them just because they make a mistake. And I hope that this council will understand that. We are going to lower the standards. I know Mr. Lohr also made the statement, I want to see parish growth. It was in the paper. And that he wasn't interested in arguing with people who dealt in hysterics. Well, I hate to say it, I'm not hysterical. I got character and I got principles and I'm sticking to them. These people that spoke tonight, they're not hysterical. They're not dealing in hysterics. They're dealing in their quality of life issues and the fact that cronyism is alive and well, because that's why we're dealing with this situation tonight.
Any more discussion? Councilman Lohr.
Councilman Valentine, I'm just curious. You mentioned Highway 73 is the other major artery in this parish. You also mentioned at the last council meeting that there were two strip mall developments in your district on Highway 73, and they did not have alcohol in them, which is incorrect. Actually, there's a daiquiri shop that is going basically across the street from the library that's being built. And there's also and you signed that permit, actually, and 13 other alcohol permits, including one of the market that is on the corner of 73 and 74. That is basically on the campus of the school, of the primary school, and that sells alcohol. So I'm not saying you're hysterical. You know exactly who I was talking about, I believe. There are people who, like I said, who believe passionately in this. But I'm just curious, the political grandstanding and the rhetoric not matching up with actions of the past.
Mr. Chairman.
More discussion. Councilman Valentine.
One, the daiquiri shop is outside the 500-foot mark of the Dutchtown School, which was there when it was built. It met all specifications to the parish standard code at the time. The parish library was not even built at the time. The property was not even secured at the time. and it is now. That's what the difference is. You better go back and check. And check your records on that situation. Each council member signs. I'm going to tell you, I don't like signing liquor license. I'm going to tell you that right now. But each councilman signs, has to sign a liquor license after the sheriff or before the sheriff checks, does background checks on liquor license. I don't like that law either, but that's a law, okay? I'm going to defend my principles to the T. So I would check your facts, Mr. Lowell.
I'm going to call a question on the motion.
Councilman Johnson.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. In the research that I've done on this ordinance since it was brought to us, I think there's some misconceptions on a few folks for part. One of the things, if we talk about 500 feet or 300 feet, depending on which law that, or ordinance that you're looking at, in the conversations that I've had with Mr. Compton and others, if you read the definition of how this is measured, you could basically have two buildings 50 foot apart, but still meet the 300 or the 500 foot mark, because you're measuring from the right-of-way at the property line to the building. If the buildings are 50 foot off the property line and they're 250 feet back, they meet the 300 foot mark. Same thing with the 500 foot distance, okay? So the misconception of it being 500 linear feet or distance-wise from building to building is not in this ordinance on the parish or on the state. One of the other things that's in here that concerns me, but it's not part of the amendment, is that we're restricting alcohol sales from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. I got three kids. They're in school at that time. What does it matter if you sell alcohol between 7 a.m. and 3 p.m.? But we're not amending that either, okay? Part of the issue with this as well is that, as Mr. Valentine just stated, it may be past the 500-foot mark, but the library on 73 is being built, in fact, to an existing daiquiri shop that is there. I didn't receive one phone call on that one. Now, the distances don't match up, but it's still the principle. I cannot regulate anybody's morals. I cannot regulate your judgment or anything else. Like Mr. Lambert said, I too have been to accidents and pulled dead kids and dead people out of cars from drunks. A friend of mine, I had to do that too. It upsets me greatly. Not to mention I've got three kids. I don't see, when you're talking 60-something feet, folks, where this is making as much of a problem as what we're making it out to be when we're talking about a restaurant. When you go to change an ordinance, you and from what I understand, and I haven't been doing this very long, but basically when you adopt ordinance as a wholesale thing, it's when you adopt a charter, adopt a constitution, or when you adopt zoning ordinances. From that point on, you're basically going in and either introducing ordinances or amending ordinances to fit certain situations. Other than that, when are you going to change them? It's when somebody brings them to you with a situation that's developed that they want to try to amend it, and it's up to us as the body of that governing authority to make the decision whether or not we want to grant that variance. But that's how that process works, and that's what is going through with this. It's one of the things that I understand it's very passionate, and there's issues within our ordinance. This is not perfect, but I think when we talk about a restaurant going in those areas, it's not about the money coming into the parish. It's about improving the parish. I don't see where it's that big of a detriment to the parish to have a restaurant in a rural area. The library that we're talking about was built across the street from an active bar when it was built. Not a restaurant, anything else. It was a bar. Cat a corner down the road a little ways. So that doesn't make it right, but it's just different. If we're coming into the point of where we're talking about a restaurant coming in next to a library or a school or anything, why aren't we talking about a library going in next to a daiquiri shop? Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, so President Martinez.
I just want to clarify the law, if y'all would allow me to. Again, on December 4th, 1975, was the first time Ascension Parish enacted an alcoholic license and permit type situation. At that time, it didn't matter how close or how far it was. If you met all the qualifications, you could certainly get a liquor license to open a bar or whatever you wanted to do. Now in 1994, when the Home Rule Charter came into effect. That changed, so we had to adopt a new ordinance. Okay, when that new ordinance came in, the 500 feet rule was put in place. But the law also says, and it doesn't matter what the sheriff says, okay? The law says that the power to issue licenses or not issue licenses rests solely with the council. And in 1968, we amended the law again, because under the 1975 statute, it gave the power to sign those licenses to the president of the police jury and the treasurer. So at that point in 68, the council voted, and it was a big, I'm at 98.
Too late.
Council voted. I was when I graduated, so I kind of went back. But, 1998, it gave the power, and it's a big burden, okay, to the chairman of the council. So the chairman of the council can decide at this point who gets the license. It doesn't matter how many feet, okay? The chairman of the council can sign a permit or not sign a permit. At that point, if that person who applied for that permit challenges the council's chairman's decision, he can come to the council to appeal. So again, I'm just clarifying. I heard Mr. Valentine make a statement. And when you were parish chairman for 2 years, you and solely you made the decisions on who in Ascension Parish could get a license and not get a license. And it also says in that law that the chairman of the council can designate that authority to whomever he'd like on the council. So if you want to look at this thing, each of you in your own districts, no matter what the how close something is or how far it is, can actually make a decision if you want alcohol anywhere in your district. It doesn't matter how many feet. So if you want, I just want to clarify the law to you. I don't drink, so it don't matter how many feet it is. My wife doesn't drink, my brother doesn't drink, my sister don't drink. So again, as far as my personal choice, that's my choice. But again, the law puts the responsibility, and Mr. Painter, I think, can verify this, that if the parish council, or at this time, the chairman of the council, refuses to sign it, they will not be issued a state license, or if they have been issued a state license, that license will be withdrawn. So, Mr. Painter, if you want to maybe clarify that, I would appreciate it. You're still here.
Mr. President, everything that you said, as I understand it, is accurate. In all parishes, and I have a court case that we handle back 4 or 5 years ago, where a parish issued a license and it was within a certain distance, and we went against the parish as far as issuing a state license because the local ordinance didn't approve. It was 200 feet, I believe, in one of the Florida parishes. The court upheld us not issuing that license, but the only reason it did, it said because the Florida parishes operate under a different rule of law, and they can't make an exception to their law. But that every other parish in the state, regardless of what the distance is that they have in their ordinance, has the authority to make an amendment to that deal and issue a license. And under that scenario, the state would issue a license if the parish issued a license. If you choose not to issue a license, regardless of what the distance is, you have to have both licenses in order to operate in this state. You have to have a state license and a local license. And if you don't have either one, you cannot operate. Now, certainly the option of anybody at that point is to file suit against either one of us. the state or the parish to argue whether you made the decision under the right circumstances or not. But what President Martinez said, you can make an exception. You can make a decision, an exception to your ordinance.
Mr. Chairman, I got a question for Mr. Painter.
Councilman Lambert.
Yeah, Mr. Painter, you know, this ordinance is law when the parish council approves it. It's 500 feet. I think Mr. President said a councilman or a chairman can sign a liquor license on any amount of feet. But does that supersede a law that was passed by the full council? Or ordinance is law?
The councilman signing it would not bear the burden
of the ordinance
of the state. Uh-huh. If we went into that situation and there was an argument over it, because we probably wouldn't know about it unless there was an argument, although we try to investigate every case on its own merit. But if you issue a license and it's 200 feet and your ordinance says 500 feet, the only way that we would issue a license under that scenario would be if the governing body of that parish passed a resolution saying that they were specifically making an exception to whatever distance y'all have already agreed upon as an ordinance to vary the distance. So if it was 500 feet, you wanted to grant one for 200 feet or 100 feet. If the council voted on it and you wasn't in one of the Florida parishes, our understanding and the court records that I understand, you have the authority to make by resolution of the governing authority to make an exception to that ordinance.
And that is the entire governing body, not just say the chairman. I think Mr.
Patterson
said that the chairman couldn't make a decision.
One individual that might satisfy the local situation,
right,
or the local part.
Right. Like I said, ordinance right here, that's law. When we pass an ordinance, that's law. So I can't see where, you know, is this a home rule charter telling it that
the home rule? Ms. Linda, you may want to add something to this, but let me clarify, Mr. Lambert, what I am saying. I'm going to say, Mr. Bell, somebody comes in and applies for a license. Right now, he has the authority given by you as the governing body through this motion, the authority to sign or not sign a permit. Now, if nobody, if Mr. Bell, I'll just take it, if Mr. Bell doesn't like Mr. Valentine, Mr. Valentine's trying to open up an establishment. If Mr. Bell does not sign that permit, okay, and Mr. Painter checks on the local issuance and the local permit, if it's not signed, you can pull your state permit. Is that correct? That's my point. So right now, that power, what I'm trying to explain to you, Mr. Lambert, is that power rests solely in the council chairman. And this is the ordinance that was amended in 1998. So it is the force of law. But it doesn't say that he has to sign it, because the power rests solely with the council on whether to issue or not issue a license to an individual. It doesn't say you have to have reasons. It says that power rests with the council. And in 1998, that council gave the power to the chairman of the council to either sign or not sign to make that decision for them. So my example is, again, Mr. Bell does not like Mr. Valentine. Mr. Valentine wants to open a restaurant with a liquor license, and even though you meet the criteria that's set forth in this, it's not valid until he signs it. He can refuse to sign it under the current law. So if he wants to designate each one of you to sign licenses in your districts, he can do so. And then at that point, you can decide if they ever sell liquor, any new establishments ever come in or not come into your district. Because if you refuse to sign that license, you're not mandated to sign it. So it doesn't matter. So again, if your character is different from Mr. Bell's character, and you don't want a proliferation new licenses in your district, you have that option. And I'm sure this council won't go against you.
Mr. Chair.
So, again, I'm just explaining. I think, I don't know if anybody ever really realized what the law was in this situation. And I'm glad Mr. Painter came tonight because I think he can also verify. If the local license is not requirements and the local license is not signed, they're going to pull the state license even though they issued it. And I don't know if, I don't want to speak incorrectly, but I think that's it.
I mean, certainly everything is argumentative, and that's why we're here, and legal counsel is here the same way. I'm sure she understands. If you withhold that license, we're not going to issue a license. If you issue that license in variance to your local ordinance, we will not accept that license unless it's a resolution of the council. Now, certainly, and I want to bring up some information for you, which is the reason that I'm here. The state law allows any parochial voting district, which is each one of your election districts is a parochial election district. All you need is 25% of the registered voters in that district. If you sign a petition at any time, you can have an election in that district itself to decide whether you want alcohol or not, or what forms you want it or don't want it. The state law allows that option for each individual down to the community level, which is the way that the theory of alcohol control works, down to the election district or ward level of a community, for the community to decide which way that it wants to handle its alcohol control. And I'm not here talking for it. I'm not here talking against it. I'm the same way like the parish president. I don't drink. I don't have a dog in that hunt one way or the other. I'm here strictly as I would want to say a professional witness instead of an expert witness, and I was asked to give factual information, and that's what I'm here to do.
Chair. Councilman Joseph.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You know, my little short time since I've been in office up here, I haven't seen us stop an individual building a gazebo within the parish right-of-way because he built it, and that right-of-way, drainage right-of-way, he built it after the fact. He put it on, and he came here and asked for a variance. And this board here told him he have to tear it down. We didn't approve it. It was after the fact. And I have a problem by being from the military. Do not create problems after the fact. I mean, I'm going to have to hardly say honestly, at first I agreed to this here ordinance. It was looking good. It was. And now, since Mr. Payne has been here, and he just told me that, like we have lighting district. You know, some of us have lighting district in this parish, and some of us don't. You know, so right now, based on the information I just received, and based on the phone calls and emails I got, and in my district, I do not have one bar. I do not have one restaurant outside the city limits of Donsonville. You know? I don't even have a library in my district. You know? But, you know, integrity, you know, children, you know, just tonight, in the past week, I just can't see myself voting for this here. I would, you know, let it stay 500 feet. The governing body in the past made a decision. I think it was wise now, and I think we need to leave it that way. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Councilman Valentine?
I'm going to have to disagree with the parish president. No, only because parish president, I'm not disagreeing with you because of what you think. Maybe I don't like you. That has nothing to do with it. And I do like you, believe me. What I disagree with is the fact that I was shown a memorandum. This didn't occur when I became chairman. This occurred when I became a council member. That the liquor license because of a resolution when Moose Pierce was chairman, was passed by the Ascension Parish Council that each councilman would sign the deal. Now, Ricky Babin showed me that, okay? Because I had a problem with doing that. I said, can somebody else sign this instead of this? And so that's what was told to me by council at that time, 5 years ago. And that's what I relied on. The question was, if they meet the criteria to all of our ordinances and laws, then essentially you had to sign. If now you're telling me I refuse, I'm not going to take your word. I'm going to take the Attorney General's word as far as whether that's correct or not. Okay, I'm making a statement. You made your statement. I'm going to make my statement. I'm going to check it and find out if it's true. And from now on, be warned. Go somewhere else and get your liquor license signed, because I'm not going to sign it. Don't have nothing to do. I just don't want to add to the situation. I'm not going to say they can't operate in the businesses. This council decides they want to operate and they can operate, they can do it. I'm not going to make no glorified Dutch town where it's liquor free. That's not my goal. My goal is just to keep the standard that we have now. And I'll ask you, what is your opinion of the standard we have now? And what is your advice to this council?
Okay, Mr. Valentine. In 1994, I was parish president. All right, when the 500 feet was invoked. 1998, I was here when this was done, so that's why I'm telling you that. And if it changed any time in between there, I don't know. But again, on my personal character and morals and my choices, as I told you earlier, I don't drink, okay? So it wouldn't be a bar room, it wouldn't be a restaurant that sells alcohol, I might would eat, but it wouldn't be anything here. But again, I'm not here to judge what other people do. I'm not here
for a recommendation from the administration. Give us your recommendation on this issue.
I would tell you this. I don't have a problem with a restaurant.
So you don't have a problem with us changing?
No, I don't have a problem.
Okay, that's what
I want. And if that's what you want to hear, I know why you want to hear.
That's not what I want to hear, but I want to know your opinion.
But I know why you want to hear.
Okay.
But anyway, it's okay. But again, I still say that's just my feeling. I don't vote up here. You guys vote.
I understand.
If I'd have wanted to vote on it, I would have certainly ran for council.
Thank you, Perry.
The other thing, I agree with Mr. Bledsoe as far as setting the principles high, okay?
You can't have it both ways.
No, nope. Listen.
You either for it or you against it.
I'm not going to debate you with that. I told you what my stance was there. But again, as far as building codes, it was a tough decision to make. I'm sure this is not an easy decision for a lot of these councilmen up here. But I was there, and I was thinking about leaving town when we passed the building codes, okay? Because I had a lot of friends of mine that didn't like me after. But looking forward now, it was a good decision, okay? I don't have a problem, again, with the 500 feet or the 300 feet, whatever which way you want to do it. I got a problem that you still have those exceptions, okay? If Mr. Valentine, I think I told you this the other night, family owns a substantial amount of property, pretty close to Dutchtown High School. There's an exception in there. If you sell your property, that they can build a hotel there. They can have a full-fledged bar, can have a full-fledged restaurant with alcohol. I think they...
It's permitted by law, though. That's the whole point.
That's all right, but I mean, if we
they just read that while
ago. Wait, but if you got that high moral standards, you need to take away that exception also. You need to make a motion to do that. The other thing is, with the convenience stores, with the hours, and I guess the Chevron at 73 and 74, you're saying that since these people can buy it there, take it home and drink it, they're not supposed to do anything with it. I don't see a whole lot of difference there, because I know they can go right into their car, open up a beer, sit there and drink it. You know, that's another enforcement issue. But it within that corridor on 73, you got several places that can sell alcohol. I'm against, I would like to see the 300 feet back for convenience stores with no exceptions, okay? Right now, there's no, I don't think there's any footage attached to your convenience store ordinance. So, I mean, you can get just as drunk sitting in a convenience store parking lot as you can in a restaurant. So, you know, we could rationalize this in a thousand ways. I mean, just because you, I mean, I don't know how many people in here that follow the speed limit to the law, but, you know, and sometimes in school zones, they don't follow the law. Again, that puts our children in jeopardy. I mean, I go to church fairs where they sell alcohol. I go to school fairs where they sell alcohol. Kids are there. Should we prohibit that? I don't know. I mean, that's a decision that you'd have to make. And I'm sure you signed some of those church permits in your area where they sell alcohol. I don't know. But again, that's your decision and your morals. I'm not going to try to legislate what I think on anybody else. I know what I believe. I don't judge anybody unless I'm judged. Okay? I can quote scripture also. But again, that's my choice. But do I think that this restaurant, this particular restaurant, rather it's 40 feet away from the 500 mark, is going to proliferate drunken drivingness and alcoholism in Ascension Parish? No. I don't think that. I don't think, whatever the footage is, we can't hold a gun to people's head and ask them not to go and have a drink or get drunk. We're not going to stop that. Same thing, we got laws about illegal drugs. We got a jail full of illegal drugs. We're expanding the jail now at $12.5 million cost to the taxpayers. So, I mean, I could go on and rationalize, but again, I answered your question in a roundabout way, and hopefully in a direct way on one issue. But anything else?
Councilman Shakesnyder.
Real quick. We change rules every day. The reason we change rules is because people bring it to our attention. Next month, they're going to bring out something to our attention that we need to review again. That's our job. Things change over time. Mr. Martinez made some examples of how things change a certain way. A couple things that bothered me about this is that it was insinuations that things were going on under the table and things were going on as personal favors. I resent that very much. In fact, to the point that I made it a point as we went through this process, which started about 6 months ago, I called periodically councilmen, and I'm pretty sure I called every one of them and asked their opinions about, because that first proposal for this was to put a daiquiri shop and it was within the 500-foot area. We told them no. I kind of polled the council. It was overwhelmingly no. Still no to this day. No daiquiri shops, no lounges, no ballrooms, no strip clubs. Very plainly, no. In reviewing that, they came back a number of times. Is there any other thing? What? And in reviewing that, we looked at it and we said, you know, I was wondering what the problem was with the restaurant. Well, restaurants go in the same category, we found out. But they couldn't put a restaurant. Well, I happen to enjoy going to restaurants. I bring my family to a restaurant. When my child has a birthday, we go to a restaurant and we go to Snow's. There's people over there, and I tell them, look, this is the bar. This is what you do over there. You do good or you do bad. And we go eat, and we enjoy ourselves as a family, and we go home. We go to the cabin. We go to Kamal's. We go to the Grapevine. We spend our money in Ascension Parish, and we do it as a family. I resent the fact that it's implied that restaurants are bad for the parish. If you come here tonight and you listen to a number of people, you would think that I better hold my children when I go into a restaurant. I don't feel that way at all. I don't feel that way that we are doing anything that's going to harm the people in the parish to change of having restaurants located a distance of 500 feet to a distance of 300 feet from a public institution. If I did, I would vote against it. I really don't think it matters that 200-foot distance in the effects of people going and having a few drinks in a restaurant or not, wherever it's located. So that is why we looked at it and we continued on, and as I polled the council appeared to be overwhelmingly for putting a restaurant, allowing a restaurants within that area, still meeting the what we were told was a state statute of 300 feet, but making exceptions to other things and not allowing the things that were principally for people to come there and drink. That's solely why it was. The people that came to us for a request were turned down 6 months ago, 3 months ago, and today. And we offered something that was, I felt, common sense, and that it would not, it would also be protective of the people of this parish. I've had conversations with law enforcement, and they could not show me any substances as to the difference in problems with drinking and accidents wherever it's located within the parish. So unless we decide to abolish restaurants that serve alcohol throughout the parish, we have the same amount of problems as we have them within 300 to 500 feet. So therefore, I have no opposition to this. And I appreciate people that come in here and try to bring a good business to this parish and act responsibly. And I ask that our families get together and our churches get together and teach proper moral attitude and proper moral behavior, and our children can follow that. And we can also do it by good good examples. And so let's just move forward.
Mr. Chairman.
Councilman Todd Lambert.
Yeah, Mr. Shakes, now you're talking about we come in, we change things. Yes, we do. But, you know, we don't have to lower our standards. We could keep our standards higher in Ascension Parish. Also, about polling the council, I was warned that you didn't poll. So apparently, I don't know, I believe that might be unethical to call every councilman and poll them. I'm not sure about that. But anyway, I wasn't polled on that, just to let you know. I guess I'm not part of that team. But just to make a change, to lower the standards, yeah, we change things. That's what we do up here. But to lower the standards, that's a moral issue that I see. And we can't go that route.
Okay, Councilman, any more discussion? We've got an amended motion and a second. Any more discussion? Do I have any objection?
I object.
I've got to need a roll call, Mrs. Zahn.
Councilman Kulot.
I'm for it.
Councilman Cullen.
Yes.
Councilman Johnson.
Yes.
Councilman Joseph.
No.
Councilman Dempsey Lambert.
Yes.
Councilman Todd Lambert.
No.
Councilman Lohr.
Yes.
Councilman Shakesnyder.
Yes.
Councilman Valentine.
No.
We have six yeas and three nays.
Part of the team.
Ordinance passes. Right. Councilman, this time I would like to say that from now on out, anytime we have a permit, each councilman will sign in his own district for alcohol. You have that opportunity, yay or nay. Number 22, reading of an ordinance. Ms. Amanda, please.
Purpose, to amend the Ascension Parish zoning map by rezoning a certain parcel of land from business park to transitional. Whereas the Parish of Ascension has in effect a comprehensive plan of zoning, and pursuant to that plan, a parish-wide development code was adopted by the Ascension Parish Governing Authority, which became effective on June 1, 1999. Whereas the Ascension Parish Development Code provides for a procedure for its amendment to allow the rezoning of property to a different classification. Whereas the herein below described property is located as such that rezoning the property is in conformity with the adjacent land uses in conformity with the general land use plan of the parish, not injurious to adjacent properties, and fully meets the qualifications for rezoning.
Some quiet, please. Go ahead.
Set forth under Louisiana law. Be it ordained that the following described property be rezoned from business park to transition for Hard Times Plantation for certain parcel of land situated in the parish of Ascension, located on the east and west side of LA Highway 75, approximately 2.74 miles south of Ashland Road, to amend the Ascension Parish zoning map from business park to transitional, and being more described as two certain tracts of land situated in section 34, 35, 36, Township 10 South, Range 2 East, Ascension Parish, Louisiana, said tracts being described as lot 2 containing 88.963 acres and lot 3 containing 16.243 acres as shown on the plat entitled Survey of Property Located in Section 34, 35, 36, and 37, Ascension Parish, Louisiana, by Charles McDonald Land Surveyors. Said lot 2 and lot 3 being further described by reference to said map of survey as follows. Being at a point marked by the letter A on said map, at which point is marked by a 1-inch pipe and is the northeast corner of said lot number 2, thence measured south 71 degrees 14 minutes west, a distance of 326.63 feet to a point marked B on said map, then measured 69 degrees 51 minutes west, a distance of 279.51 feet to a point marked C, thence measured south 70 degrees 26 minutes west, a distance of 275.88 feet to a point marked D, thence proceed south 72 degrees 47 minutes west, a distance of 191.07 feet to a point marked E on said map. Thence measure south 73 degrees 29 minutes west, a distance of 179.85 feet marked F on said map. Then measure south 75 degrees west, a distance of 174.9 feet to G. Then measure south 72 degrees west, a distance of 478.17 feet to a point marked H. Then to a point 1-inch iron pipe, at which point is common to the southeast corner of said lot 2 and northeast corner of said lot 3. Then measure south 71 degrees 0 minutes west, a distance of 270.6 feet to a point marked letter I. Thence measure north 73 degrees 26 minutes west, a distance of 2,067.57 feet to a point marked by the letter J on said map. Thence measure along the meander of the low water mark of the Mississippi River, a distance of 586.39 feet more or less to a point K on said map. Then proceed along the said meander low mark water mark of the Mississippi River, a distance of 1,596.69 feet more or less to the letter L on said map, which point is the northwest corner of said lot number 2, then measures south 60 degrees 20 minutes east, a distance of 3,122.62 feet to the point marked A on said map. Be it further ordained that the land use map of Ascension Parish Development Code be amended to reflect these rezonings and that the Office of Planning and Zoning be authorized to make such changes.
Need a motion to open public hearing, please.
Move to open
public hearing. Moved by Councilman Chase Nyer, second by Councilman Dempsey Lambert. Anyone wishing to speak on this item, please come forward. You'll be allotted 3 minutes.
Motion to close.
Motion to close by Councilman Todd Lambert.
That was Benny.
Who gives the motion?
Benny.
All right, motion to close by Councilman Benny Johnson. Second by Councilman Cullen. Need a motion for the ordinance, please.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Moved by Councilman Dempsey Lambert.
Second.
Second by Councilman Dennis Cullen. Any discussion? Any objection? Ordinance passes. Item 25, Ms. Mather.
Purpose, to amend the Ascension Parish Subdivision Regulation, Section 20.203D. Whereas the Parish of Ascension has in effect a comprehensive plan of zoning, and pursuant to that plan, a parish-wide development code was adopted by the Ascension Parish Governing Authority, which became effective on June 1, 1999. Whereas the Ascension Parish Development Code provides for a procedure for its amendment of the development code and related regulations and restrictions by initiation of the Parish Planning and Zoning Commission. Whereas the Parish Planning and Zoning Commission has initiated an amendment to Section 20.203D of the Ascension Parish Subdivision Regulations to read as follows. Now, therefore, be it ordained that Section 20.203D of the Ascension Parish Subdivision Regulations is amended to read as follows. Changes of substantial nature defined as follows. Any changes made by the owner subdivider subsequent to approval of the preliminary plat shall be submitted in electronic format and reviewed by the Planning Commission Chairman and his staff. If the change suggested by the owner subdivider is to be of a substantial nature, which is defined as a change in the size of lots amounting to an increase of 10% or more of the total number of lots from the previously approved plat, redesign of the subdivision or any portion thereof which would change the street pattern or overall layout of the previously approved plat, relocation or addition of any sewage treatment facility, relocation or addition of addition of any drainage facility except as mandated by an agency with the legal authority to govern the change. A change in the amount of green space dedicated amounting to a reduction of 10% or more from the previously approved plat. Then approval can only be granted by the Planning Commission and then only after a public hearing is held for that purpose. If the suggested change is not substantial in nature, then approval will be granted immediately.
Need a motion to open public hearing, please.
Motion.
Motion by Councilman Cluart.
Second.
Second by Councilman Bennett Johnson. Anyone wish to speak on this matter, please come forward. You'll be allotted 3 minutes.
Motion to close.
Motion to close. Councilman Chris Lohr.
Second.
Second by Councilman Cluart. I need a motion for the ordinance, please.
Move the ordinance, Mr. Chairman.
Moved to ordinance by Councilman Johnson, second by Councilman Dempsey Lambert. Any discussion? Any objection? Ordinance passes. Number 28, please, ma'am.
Purpose, to declare the below-described property a surplus and transfer the title pursuant to a cooperative endeavor agreement. Whereas the Parish of Ascension owns a Ford pumper engine with a vehicle identification number of F82JVAG5527 that is surplus equipment and is no longer needed by the parish. Whereas the Sorrento Volunteer Fire Department, Inc., has need for this equipment and is willing to offer valuable services to the Parish of Ascension in exchange for said equipment. Be it hereby ordained that the Ascension Parish Council, as the governing authority in and for the Parish of Ascension, is hereby declare the aforementioned vehicle to be surplus and authorize the conveyance and transfer of all rights, title, and interest in one Ford pumper engine with the vehicle identification number of F82JVAG5527, the Sorrento Volunteer Fire Department, Inc., as is and without warranty of any kind for the terms and conditions as set forth in the cooperative endeavor agreement attached hereto and made a part hereof.
Motion to open public
move
hearing,
open
please.
Public
motion
hearing.
By Councilman Schneider. Second by Councilman Johnson. Anyone wish to speak on this matter, please come forward. You'll be allotted 3 minutes.
Move to close.
Move to close by Councilman Schneider. Second by Councilman Benny Johnson. A motion for the ordinance, please.
Motion,
Johnson. Motion by Councilman Johnson. Second by Councilman Cluart. Any discussion? Any objection? Ordinance passes. Next item, 31, Councilman Todd Lambert, please.
Motion to adjourn.